Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever is not against me is for me." What's interesting, though, is that Jesus in another passage says, "Whoever is not for me is against me." So, which is it? Is this a contradiction? No. See, for Jesus, they're both right because of one reason, because of context. Now, he was speaking to two different audiences, and well, each audience needed to hear something different that Jesus had to say to them. In Luke 9, where Jesus says, "Whoever is not against me is for me," he's speaking to the disciples. And his disciples, here's their issue. They're complaining that there are other people out there casting out demons in Jesus' names. Now, this comes right after the section where the disciples are arguing who among them is the greatest. See, the problem was that they were jealous that there were others out there ministering in Jesus' name, and they did not get the credit or glory. So it actually makes sense that Jesus would tell them, "Hey, whoever is not against me is for me." But in Matthew 12, in another section, Jesus says, "Whoever is not against me is for me." Now, in this case, he's speaking to the Pharisees. Their issue was that they saw how powerful Jesus was with his miracles, but they did not really believe that he was the Messiah. So Jesus tells them that they need to believe in him 100% because he will later sit on the throne of judgment. In other words, for Jesus, there is no middle ground for believing in him. Either you're for him or you're against him. Either in or you're out. All in, all out. So now these words make sense. Whoever is not for me is against me. So there you go, a little bit about this phrase, and that's enough today for our historical minute.